Welcome to Modular Classroom. In Artificial Intelligence series, today we are going to see about statistical reasoning. So, before entering to statistical reasoning, first, what is reasoning? The reasoning is nothing but it is a mental process of deriving logical conclusion and making predictions from available knowledge, facts, and beliefs. Reasoning is a way to infer facts from the existing data. It is a general process of thinking rationally to find valid conclusions. In artificial intelligence, the reasoning is essential so that the machine can also think rationally as a human brain and can perform like a human. So the machine is going to think like a human and it is going to take decision. That capability of inferring knowledge is called as reasoning. So symbolic versus statistical reasoning of two types. Symbolic methods basically represent the uncertainty belief as being true, false, or neither true nor false. Some methods also had problems with incomplete knowledge and contradictions in the knowledge. So, statistical methods provide a method for representing beliefs that are uncertain but for which there may be some supporting or contradictory evidence. This is useful for dealing with problems where there is randomness and unpredictability. This you can say in the example like of games of chance probabilities. To do all this in a principled way requires techniques for probabilistic reasoning. So what does a probabilistic reasoning means? It is a way of knowledge representation where we apply the concept of probability to indicate the uncertainty in knowledge. In the real world, there are lots of scenarios where the certainty of something is not confirmed, such as it will rain today, behavior of someone for some situations, and a match between two teams or two players. So these are probable sentences for which we can assume that it will happen but not sure about it. That is, it will rain today, it may happen, but it also we come to know that it will not rain today also. It will not rain today also. Some common terms that is used in probabilistic reasoning are: probability can be defined as a chance that an uncertain event will occur. That is, it is a numerical measure of the likelihood that an event will occur. The value of probability always remains between zeros and one, and that represent ideal uncertainties. If it lies between 0 to 1, where P of A is the probability of an event A. If it is equal to 0, it indicates total uncertainty in an event A. If probability of A equal to 1, it indicates total certainty in an event A. So, can find the probability of an uncertain event by using the below formula. Probability of occurrence is equal to number of desired outcomes divided by total number of outcomes. Another formula is probability of negation of A means it means probability of a not happening event. That is, A is the event that is not going to happen. That negation and that event, if you sum, it will get the value 1. So that's the example of a dice where the number of aces divided by the number of cards in deck, that is said as 1 by 13. So the probability of being dealt with a spade is 1 by 4. This has been substituted in this formula. Next comes the most important concept is Bayes' theorem. This is a person called Thomas Bayes. He was a British mathematician and he derived the theorem Bayes. It's also known as Bayes' rule, Bayes' law, or Bayesian reasoning, which determines the probability of event with uncertain knowledge. So the Bayesian inference is an application of Bayes' theorem, which is fundamental to Bayesian statistics. It is a way to calculate the value of P of B conditional probability of A with the knowledge of P given A conditional probability of B. It allows updating the probability prediction of event by observing new information of the real world. So important goal for many problem solving systems is to collect evidence as the system goes along and to modify its behavior on the basis of evidence. To model this behavior, a statistical theory of evidence is needed. That comes the Bayesian statistics. So the fundamental notion of Bayesian statistics is nothing but conditional probability. Uncertainty means it is defined as a lack of the exact knowledge that would enable to reach a perfectly reliable conclusion. That is lack of exact knowledge, but you will come to a conclusion. That is called uncertainty. But the probability of event is a proportion of cases in which the event occurs. Can also be defined as a scientific measure of chance. Bayesian reasoning, some of the rules exist. That is, if E is true, then H is true with probability P. This rule implies that if event E occurs, then the probability that event H will occur in is P. H usually represents a hypothesis. E denotes evidence to support this hypothesis. So H is the hypothesis and E is the evidence that supporting this hypothesis. This is the notation that is used in the Bayes theorem, where the conditional probability derives like P of Hi bar E means it is a probability that hypothesis Hi is true given evidence E. P of E bar Hi means it is a conditional probability that will observe evidence E given that hypothesis I is true. H of I means it is a priori probability. H means number of possible hypotheses. From this, the formula given in Bayes theorem is, this is a formula derived, that is P of Hi conditional probability E is equal to E of that is observing here prior probability and the summation. We will see in another notation. So this is the formula represented where this P of H denotes your prior probability and this denotes your likelihood of the evidence and this gives a prior probability that the evidence itself is true. From this it gives a posterior probability. So what is meant by likelihood? It is a probability of collecting this data when a hypothesis is true. Posterior means the probability of a hypothesis being true given the data collected. And prior means the probability of the hypothesis being true before collecting the data. So the marginal derivation is what is the probability of collecting this data under all possible hypotheses? This question is being given answer through this formula. So examining the geological evidence at a particular location to determine a good place to find resilient minerals. You will have some prior probabilities and you will applying this Bayes formula to compute that evidence. This is being generated as a AI program named Prospector. It is used to successfully help to locate the deposits of several minerals. So this is the success of this program by applying Bayes theorem. Because uncertain reasoning is recognizing exactly what it says. This is the condition P of A conditional B. We're describing the condition probability of A given that the only evidence we have is B. If there is also other relevant evidence in law, then it must also be considered. In real life, we have several evidence that are not independent. Example, if a patient has been spots, it has been denoted by S. If M means the patient has measles, F means patient has high fever. Without any additional evidence, the presence of spots serves as evidence in favor of measles. It also serves as evidence of fever since measles could cause fever. Spots and fever are not independent events and hence we cannot just sum their effects. There is a need to represent explicitly the conditional probability that arises from their conjunction. Here what this Bayes theorem helps in as an advantage factor. But at the same time, the Bayes theorem is intractable for several reasons. That is, some demerits of the Bayes theorem is knowledge acquisition problem is insurmountable because too many probabilities have to be provided. And next is the space that would be required to store all the probabilities is too large and the time required to compute the probabilities is also too large. So, to above mentioned problems, the solution is we have some mechanisms. If we follow that mechanism, these problems will be solved. The mechanisms are attaching certainty factors to rules, Bayesian networks, and Demeter-Shaffer theory. We will see these topics in the subsequent videos. Thanks for watching.